Thank you. Rayburn's Langsamerzatz, or Slow Movement, written in 1905 after a vacation hiking in the Alps with his girlfriend at the time, future wife. So we hope you can hear some of the romance in that. It's not a lot like the Webern that I think a lot of us may know, and his really atonal style. So next we're going to be playing a new piece by Ben Campbell, a Lawrence student, that we premiered last weekend at the Composition Studio recital. His first string quartet, it's in two movements, short movements. The first one is called Flesh, and it's full of organic, flowing shapes, lots of rubato, very expressive. And then the second movement is called Bone, and it's very rigid and exciting. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you. thank yous. The coaches we worked with this term, Ida, Michalik, Laren, very helpful. Thank you to Laren, especially for the logistical side of things, keeping us on the straight and narrow and making sure we got ourselves a date and time and a room so that all this could happen. In any case, our next and last piece is Beethoven's Quartet No. 8 in E minor. Heads up, halfway through after the second movement, Mia and I are going to stand up and switch seats. Don't worry, the piece isn't over. But in any case, this piece was written, published in 1808, and was dedicated to Prince Andrei Razumovsky, the Russian ambassador to Vienna. He was a big patron of the arts. Beethoven's 5th and 6th symphonies were dedicated to him, and Beethoven wrote his 7th, 8th, and 9th quartets for Razumovsky to play with his string quartet. Razumovsky was a violinist. And a quick little anecdote about him to get you into the headspace for this piece. Razumovsky was, he built this giant mansion in Vienna called the Palace Razumovsky. Huge thing, beautifully decorated, lots and lots of art. New Year's Eve 1814, he holds this giant party. All of Viennese high society is in attendance. The Tsar of Russia, Alexander I, is the guest of honor. Everyone's there dancing, having fun. After the party ends, though, a baking oven manages to catch fire and burn down the entire palace. Rooms, all of the art, interiors, everything is destroyed. No one's harmed, but Razumovsky never fully mentally recovers from it. He lives the rest of his life in solitude, wandering the dark and empty chambers of his mansion. And while this quartet was written more than 6 years before the devastating fire, we still feel like you can hear echoes of the future in Beethoven's music. This is one of Beethoven's biggest quartets. Not only the movements and the themes seem to revel in their material, they drag themselves out to absurd lengths. It's also really dark and heavy. It's the only quartet of the 16-17 that Beethoven wrote that ends on a minor chord. So if you listen with an open ear, you could hear things like dancing, you can hear the representations of nature and art and all its beauty, and you may be able to hear ominous fire at the base of the music. While Beethoven may not have been able to tell the future, he was the only person invited to Razumovsky's party who did not attend. So really, who can say? Anyways, thanks to all of you for coming out, and for the people watching the video in the future, we are the Kingfisher Quartet. We hope you've enjoyed the art that we have created so far, and this is Beethoven's Quartet No. 8.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.